Good evening, and we are so glad you're here in worship with us. Welcome to our Celtic Evensong. It is a service of prayer and beautiful music, quiet contemplation, and peace. We hope that you will get that out of this worship service. That's our hope for you. We also hope that you will share it with a friend of yours, that you will let them know about our worship service. Maybe send them the link. We are praying for you this day that you will find comfort in the words of this worship, comfort in the words of God. Welcome.
Welcome. A prayer for the evening. Surprising God, you have an uncomfortable habit of showing up where we least expect you, in a giant fish or a pesky worm, in the face of an enemy, in a livestock feed trough, on a rough wooden cross. We pray that you will turn our lives upside down with your radical love. Help us fully embrace your surprises, even when they scare us. Make us brave enough to seek joy as we are embraced by your all-encompassing mercy. We pray in the name of your most amazing surprise of all, your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Friends, please join me now in the prayer of intercession. O God, whose wisdom surpasses our understanding, help us to grow as a people of blessing as we offer our prayers for the church and the world. We pray for those who mourn. May they know the comfort of your abiding presence. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. We pray for our leaders, those in government, community, and church. God, guide all leaders, provide compassionate hearts, focused minds, and inspiring words that are fixed on resolution, justice, and peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. We pray for the meek. May they receive the goodness of your earth. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. We pray for those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. May they be filled with goodness. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. We pray for those who are merciful. May they receive mercy. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. We pray for the pure in heart. May they see you face to face. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. We pray for the peacemakers. May they be recognized as your children. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. We pray for those who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness. May they know the protection of your realm. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. We pray for those battling illness and all who serve them. Bless our first responders, caregivers, and researchers. Let them feel your guiding hand, and gracious God, let them know rest. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. We rejoice this day and give thanks for the many blessings of this life and for the gift of your kingdom, which is ours even now. May we, with your prophets from the ages, have the wisdom to pursue your truth and the courage to do what is holy and right. We ask all this in the name of Christ, who is our light and our life. Amen.
Our scripture reading comes from the book of Jonah. It starts in the first chapter. And I'm reading today from the Message. One day long ago, God's word came to Jonah, Amittai's son. Up on your feet and on your way to the big city of Nineveh. Preach to them. They're in a bad way and I cannot ignore it any longer. But Jonah got up and went to the other direction, to Tarshish, running away from God. He went down to the port of Joppa and found a ship that was headed to Tarshish. He paid the fare, got on board, and joining all of those, headed that direction, as far away from God as Jonah thought he could get. But God sent a huge storm at sea. The waves were towering. The ship was about to be broken into pieces. The sailors were terrified. They called out in desperation to their gods, little g gods. They threw everything they had. They threw it overboard to lighten the ship. Now, meanwhile, Jonah had gone into the hold of the ship to take a nap. He was sound asleep. The captain came up to him and said, "What is this? You're sleeping. Get up. Pray to your God. Maybe your God will see that we're in trouble and will rescue us." And then the sailors said to one another, "Let's go to the bottom of this area. Let's draw straws. We need to identify the culprit in this ship who's responsible for this disaster." So they drew straws and Jonah got the short straw. And then they grilled him. "Confess. Why is this disaster happening? What is your work? Where do you come from? What country? What family are you?" And he told them, "I'm a Hebrew, and I worship God." That's a big G God. "The God of heaven who made the sea and the land." And at that, the men were frightened. They were really frightened. And they said, "What on earth have you done?" As Jonah talked, the sailors realized he was running away from God. And they said to him, "What are we going to do with you to get rid of this storm?" And by that time, the wild wind was blowing, and it was totally out of control. And Jonah said, "Just throw me overboard. Throw me into the sea, and the storm will stop. It's all my fault. I am the cause of the storm. Get rid of me, and you will get rid of the storm." But no, the men tried rowing back to shore. They made no headway. The storm only got worse. It was wild. It was raging. And then they prayed, "God, oh God, don't let us be drawn down because of this man's life. Don't blame us for his death." your God. Do what you think is best. So they took Jonah and they threw him overboard. Immediately, the sea was quieted down. The sailors were impressed. They were no longer terrified by the sea, but they were in awe of God. They worshiped God. They offered a sacrifice, and they made vows. Then God assigned a huge fish to swallow Jonah. Jonah was in the fish's belly for 3 days and 3 nights. This is the word of God for the people of God. And we say, thanks be to God. Even if you have never read the Bible, you've probably known about this story about Jonah. For some reason, he got swallowed up into a whale, he hung out there for a few days, and then he got spit out on shore. End of story. And that's where most children's books end up. All's well that ends well on the shore. Well, it wasn't a whale. And the big sea creature, we'll just call it a big fish, probably violently, in Jonah's perspective, heaved him up on the shore. And that's not the end of the story. It's really just the beginning of the story, a story that tells us more about God and ourselves than it does about Jonah. It's a story of God's grace and salvation and stubbornness and forgiveness and timing. If we read it as it was intended, it makes us confront our view of what forgiveness and justice really look like. The story of Jonah should be looked at in its entirety. There is so much more to it than just the whale. It's a morale tale. It holds up a mirror and makes us look at a long, hard, look at ourselves. It's like one of those amazing and infuriating and thousand-piece puzzles. You know the ones I'm talking about. Our kids and I worked on one of those when we went on vacation one time. We had pieces all over this giant glass coffee table. We worked that puzzle for days. And when completed, the puzzle formed the picture of a series of front doors, beautiful and yet maddening. Sometimes I'd find two pieces that matched after searching for a ridiculously long amount of time for them. The rush of adrenaline. Will they indeed match? Will they fit? Yes! Or no. No, the two pieces of the quaintly weathered, aquamarine colored, nearly identical French doors threw me off. My son and daughter always seemed to find the right pieces faster than I could. Like Jonah, I was slow to recognize how the pieces all went together. And like Jonah, I thought the timing was not right. It occurs to me that our life right now is like a big jigsaw puzzle. This COVID-19 life of remote jobs and schools and masks and socially distanced everything feels like we're holding a puzzle piece, but we can't find the lid to the box. We don't know what it'll look like or what it's supposed to look like when it's all put together. Jonah was a lot like that. God kept providing him little puzzle pieces, but Jonah was unclear on how they fit together, much less how they would look once they were spread out on the coffee table of life. Jonah thought he could outrun God, and he ended up as fish food. That was one puzzle piece for him. Jonah did what God wanted. He warned the Ninevites, another puzzle piece. But spoiler alert, they repented and God didn't punish them into oblivion after all. That made Jonah mad. He was so angry that God let them off the eternal hook. Oh, another puzzle piece. But Jonah needed to see how it fit with the others and he just could not. The story goes on, including a strange plant that God had grown to provide shade for a pouting Jonah, only to then send a worm to destroy that plant. Jonah gets more than a little obsessed about the plant, apparently. More puzzle pieces, more lessons for Jonah. You know, I identify with his impatience with God. I also identify with his inability to try to see the bigger picture, what the pieces all look like when they are patiently and retrospectively put together. It takes time. God's time and God's timing in a giant puzzle that often only God can see the completion. I encourage you to read the book of Jonah. It's only 4 chapters. And at the end, it isn't tied up in a pretty little feel-good bow. It ends with God asking a rhetorical question of Jonah, and really of us. You're fixated on the plant and the worm and your lack of shade. But Jonah, what about the bigger picture? Why the concern about the plant and not the people? What about the necessary compassion for all the Ninevehs of Jonah's world and our world today? What about our feelings and actions toward those we consider the others? Well, no real thanks to me. We got that puzzle put together. There's even a celebratory picture that my husband took of us next to the completed puzzle. And if you look really hard, you'll notice in the midst of that puzzle, the puzzle of all those doors on that big glass coffee table, there's a missing piece. And somehow that seems okay. In the cosmic jigsaw puzzle that is our existence with our Creator, we have to trust that God is filling in the missing pieces that complete us.
The stormy sea, getting swallowed up and then spit out by a big fish. This Jonah is the stuff of children's stories. Hard work is required for us adults to dive into deeper meanings. The presence of God, the compassion we owe to the other, God's relentlessness in never giving up on us. As Jonah discovered, this life as a believer is gritty and messy, empowering and transcending. Jonah reminds us that God sees past our weaknesses, revealing our true self as originally created, a reflection of the image of God.
Here now is a blessing for God's people. May Christ shine brightly on your path as you walk the way of justice and peace, and the blessing of God the Creator, Healer, and Giver of life bless you and keep you always. Amen.